Hi, I'm Norman Wildberger, and today I'm going to look at spread polynomials, an interesting family of polynomials that arise naturally in rational trigonometry once we start looking at how you combine spreads to form new spreads. So first I will remind you a little bit about how we graph polynomials. We have the x and the y axes. In our case, we'll be thinking of x as being s instead, because s will stand for a spread. All right, so here are three polynomials, s1, s2, and s3, and they're graphs. So s1 of s is s, that's the function whose value at 0.5 is 0.5, whose value at 0.75 is 0.75. s2 in black is the second spread polynomial, 4s times 1 minus s. It's actually a parabola, it's a second degree curve, which goes through these two points and that point, and goes also go through here and here. The third spread polynomial is s times 3 minus 4s all squared, and it is a cubic, it looks like this, and we're only interested in the values between 0 and 1. All the higher spread polynomials bounce around in this box, up and down, beautifully encompassed by that little box. So here are some expanded values. S of 0, the zeroth polynomial, is by definition 0. There's S1 of S, we've already seen. Here's S2 of S, also called the logistic map. It's a very important function in chaos theory. Here we've written it out in an expanded form, in factored form, in expanded form. Both forms will be interesting. S3 of S, we've already seen it, there's its expanded form. Here's S4 of S, factored form, expanded form. S5 of S, factored form, expanded form. Now there's a nice pattern to these coefficients that we're going to talk about a little bit later on. But right now I want to explain how we get these spread polynomials, how do they arise from rational trigonometry. Spread polynomials arise from rational trigonometry, in particular from the triple spread formula, which is usually a formula about three spreads formed by a triangle. Now, if you have a triangle and you move one of those lines to the other vertex, you still have exactly the same three spreads, and you have three spreads formed by three concurrent lines, and they still obey the triple spread formula. Now for us, what's going to be interesting is what happens when two of those spreads are the same. So we imagine that this spread, S, is the same as this spread. And then we're interested in, well, what's the spread between the first and the third line? We'll call that R. So if we replace these things with S's and R's, we have 2s plus r squared on the left. Here we have 2 times 2s squared plus r squared plus 4s squared r. All right, we expand this. There's a 4s squared factor which cancels with that one. We have 4sr plus r squared left here. On this side we have 2r squared plus 4s squared r. We bring everything to the right-hand side, so the r squared there subtracts with that one, minus 4sr over on this side. We have 0 equals r squared minus 4sr plus 4s squared r. There's a factor of r common here, we'll factor that out, and here's what's remaining. If the product of these two things is 0, then either r equals 0 or this expression is 0, and that's saying that r equals 4s minus 4s squared. And that's the expression for R in terms of S. That's the second spread polynomial. The higher spread polynomials are obtained in exactly a parallel way. For example, the third spread polynomial you get by taking four lines, a spread of S, another spread of S, another spread of S, and asking what's the spread between the first and the last line. Well, it's the same thing. You do exactly what we did before, but now you apply the triple spread formula to an S2 of S, in other words, the second spread polynomial, and R. Okay. And then you can check that what you get is the third spread polynomial, S times 3 minus 4S, all squared. Now let's have a look at some properties of the spread polynomials. The spread polynomials can also be defined recursively. That means we start off by defining S0 of S to be 0, and S1 of S to be S. And here's the recursive rule that says what Sn of S is in terms of Sn minus 1 and Sn minus 2. So you can use this over and over, step by step, to generate all the spread polynomials. This recursive formula is quite similar to a recursive formula for a famous family of polynomials called the Chebyshev polynomials, usually denoted by T of N. Chebyshev was a famous Russian mathematician. The Chebyshev polynomials are defined by T0 of x equals 1 and T1 of x equals x, and by a recursive rule that's similar, but perhaps somewhat simpler. It turns out that there's an intimate relationship between the spread polynomials and the Chebyshev polynomials. The nth spread polynomial is 1 minus the nth Chebyshev polynomial evaluated at 1 minus 2s, all over 2. So these two families of polynomials are very closely linked, but there's some important differences. So have a look at this picture. This is a picture of the second spread polynomial, and over here is a picture of the second Chebyshev polynomial. The second spread polynomial, also called the logistic map, that's 4s times 1 minus s. It's a parabola opening downwards, contained in the box between 0, 1 and 0, 1. The second Chebyshev polynomial, in x, say, is 2x squared minus 1. That's a parabola opening upwards, contained in a box between minus 1 and 1 and minus 1 and 1. It turns out that all the standard properties of the Chebyshev polynomials that are important in applications for integration theory and for approximation theory also apply to the spread polynomials. So the spread polynomials are a potential replacement for the Chebyshev polynomials. They have, however, two very important advantages. One of them is that they have a factorization formula that's much nicer than the Chebyshev factorization formula. We'll talk about that at some other stage. And for us, the important thing is that the spread polynomials are naturally connected to geometry. In my next lecture, I'm going to have a look at one particular spread polynomial, the fifth one, which is closely related to five-fold symmetry, or the symmetry of a pentagon. The golden ratio will come up, and I hope you'll join me for that. I'm Norman Wildberger. Thanks for listening.